Greetings, and welcome to this week's Prime Insight. I'm Gavin Gooden, the Marketing Director here at BlastOne. We had a number of requests this week from companies wanting to know the correct procedure for cleaning and the sanitisation of their blast helmets. Our blasters are out there day in and day out using their blast helmets. And it's important to know and to ensure that your blaster is safe and healthy. The first thing is to all supervisors and owners of companies. No blaster should ever share a helmet with someone else. And if you've got a new blaster starting, they should always be issued with a new blast helmet. Blast helmets are a piece of protective equipment and they are personal and they should not be shared. If you don't feel you can afford to buy every blaster a new helmet when they start, you should definitely give them a completely clean helmet and sanitize the inside and put in a complete new set of liners. So the topic of hygiene. It's important to have a good daily hygiene procedure. When a blaster has finished blasting for the day, they need to complete the exterior helmet inspection, which includes looking for cracks and damage to the helmet shell, looking at the visor and the lens system, and the cape. They should then, for the internal, should take a quick inspection inside of the helmet to make sure it is clean and safe to use again the next day. So if it's clean inside, it's pretty easy to see. But you need to wipe out the inside hard surfaces with soapy water or detergent, and then ensure it is completely dry before you put it away. That's very important. It needs to be completely dry, because otherwise mold will build up. The best way to dry your helmet is to continue running your breathing air through it for at least 15 minutes, and that will dry the helmet out. The helmet should then be removed from the workplace and hung up in a clean and dry place. If the helmet has no soiling, just a smell, this is the application where you can use a commercial sanitizing aerosol spray to make sure all the pads are sanitized and to remove that smell. Once you've done that, you still want to blow air through it for at least 15 minutes to ensure it's completely dry and all odors have disappeared, because even sanitizing solution can be harmful to your respiratory system. If there's any dirt or spoiling or contamination in the helmet, you need to do a deeper clean. The first thing you need to do is take out the pads from the headliner and the bib and wash them or could replace them. Replacing the complete liner kit is often the best solution. And we have a hygiene kit here, which includes all the components you need in one packet. It includes the liners, the earpieces, includes even a wipe, which you can use to wipe out and sanitize the helmet. To wash everything is also quite simple. All the fabric components can be easily removed and then either hand washed with soap and water in a tub and thoroughly rinsed and then left to air to dry, or in a gentle washing machine on cold water. You don't want to use a clothes dryer, as this will damage the adhesive. So these components come completely out. See, look, you can completely separate all the fabric from the foam, which means you can sanitize and clean every single piece. As you understand, after you wash them, you can't use them for a couple of days until they're fully dry. This means it's often more economical to simply replace the complete liner kit when it is soiled, as this saves the cost and the time of washing and drying. If you're not going to use your helmet for a few days, it needs to be completely cleaned before you store it. Otherwise, mold and contaminants will build up. So the key message today is to: 1. Never share a helmet. 2. Make sure on a daily basis you completely clean it and dry it out. 3. We always recommend replacing the inner lining kit at least every month or as you need, depending on the cleanliness of the environment that you're working in. If you give your blaster a decent helmet, a clean helmet, he'll give you a decent day's work. As always, follow the manufacturer's instructions and any company-specific rules or requirements. And seek further advice for specialised or difficult applications. Thank you for watching this week's Prime Insight. We'll see you next week.